biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about the differences between mitosis and meiosis. So mitosis and meiosis, two types of cell division, but some critical differences between the processes. And you probably learned about them in the same unit, which means they're probably on the same test. And differences between processes make fantastic test questions. So let's dig in. All right, let's start with purpose and cell type. Remember that with mitosis, you are producing daughter cells that are identical to the original parent cell. So you're going to see mitosis performed by somatic cells, body cells, for the purposes of repairing or maintaining the body, or for growth, adding more cells to that organism. For meiosis, we're making cells that are different from the original parent cell. This is going to be done to produce gametes, and this is the process you're going to see with these sex cells. Note that mitosis is a single round of division, whereas meiosis has two divisions. Mitosis is going to produce two daughter cells that are identical to each other and to that original parent cell. Whereas after meiosis is completed, you're going to have four daughter cells that are not only different from each other, but also very different looking from that original parent cell. Okay, not too bad so far, right? Let's step it up a little bit and look at the actual divisions. DNA replication occurs during the S phase, before both mitosis and before meiosis I. That's going to produce replicated chromosomes. These are our X-shaped chromosomes that have two sister chromatids. These sister chromatids are going to be separated from one another, pulled apart towards opposite ends of our dividing cells. Now, in mitosis, this happens during anaphase. Do we separate sister chromatids during meiosis? Absolutely. This is going to happen in the second division during anaphase II. Some events are completely unique to meiosis. So during prophase I, homologous chromosomes pair up. They form structures called tetrads. Tetrads because they consist of four chromatids. While the homologous chromosomes are in close contact with each other, they can actually exchange pieces of DNA. This process is called crossing over, and it generates recombinant chromatids, chromatids that have DNA from different sources. These are no longer identical, and this is one of the ways that meiosis introduces genetic variation into our daughter cells. And the final difference that we'll note today. So in each case, our parent cell is diploid. So notice the presence of homologous chromosomes here. Do homologous chromosomes separate at some point during mitosis? Nope. We start diploid and we end diploid, right? We start with two copies of each chromosome set, means we've got homologous pairs, and we end with two copies of each chromosome set. Okay, what about during meiosis? Do homologous chromosomes separate during meiosis? They do. This occurs during anaphase of the first division. Lots of stuff happening during these anaphases, right? This is why we see a ploidy change from diploid in the parent cell to haploid at the end of the second round of division. Mitosis and meiosis have a lot in common, but it's those differences that are really important and that, as you've seen, can be a little bit tricky. So give me a like if this helped. Be sure to subscribe for even more biology content. Check out my website for more resources, and I will see you next time. Bye.